we've just exited the number 6 train at Grand Central, and here, for the first time I've seen, is a sign pointing to the Long Island Railroad. So, what? It's still St. Patrick's Day. It's about 12:40 in the afternoon, which means the parade has been going on and originates near here on 44th and 5th Avenue, but the parade has been going on for about an hour and a half. So, since the sign pointed to the Long Island Railroad, let's see where this passageway is taking us. And let's see what the nation's newest rail terminal is like on St. Patrick's Day. The two railroads that serve Grand Central Terminal, Long Island Railroad and Metro North, and I'm sure Metro North would want me to say their name first, both prohibit carrying alcohol on trains on St. Patrick's Day. They also prohibit it on maybe a few other select holidays, especially New Year's Eve. Is a shuttle from Times Square arriving. But let's follow the signage to Long Island Railroad. Okay, so despite the sign saying it's vegan, it's not. Been in Grand Central Madison before, but this passageway is new to me. Okay. Now we're in newly familiar territory. Okay, we don't want to go that way, because that's just taking us to Grand Central Classic, which we will go to in a minute. Let's say these people just arrived from somewhere on Long Island. Look at that big sign for restrooms up ahead. Especially on St. Patrick's Day. Okay. Look at this subtle green lighting. Okay. I think this is, at this point, we got to turn the camera off. Briefly. Okay. Preliminary assessment at almost 1 p.m., 12:50, on Friday, St. Patrick's Day. The men's restroom is in very good shape. Let's see. Let's go to Grand Central Classic, or the Metro North portion of Grand Central, and see whether arriving passengers there are also headed for the parade. Even she's got the St. Patrick's spirit. Dining concourse. It used to be called simply the lower level of Grand Central, but it is also a food hall. This is the most crowded I've seen the dining concourse in quite a while. By the way, if you ever have the opportunity to see the film Death Wish again, the very last scene is filmed in the lower level of Grand Central. This was back in 1974. And even though it was clearly Grand Central, in the film it was meant to be Chicago. going to the main level, the main concourse of Grand Central. Again, a little more crowded than usual on a Friday afternoon. It's doing any business today. Such a quiet day today. He's at window 5. Hurry. This is infrared. And this is what you've been watching on St. Patrick's Day. Oh. All right, well, red and pink is almost as good as green. Stay tuned, because we have a couple more bonuses coming up. Patrick's Day is bad news for bus riders. For example, this M31 bus is supposed to be going cross town on 57th Street. So it's now taking a detour down to, you know, 3/4 of a mile in each direction at least, to 42nd Street. And now, is it going to be able to turn? Yes. So, altogether, a mile and a half detour for the M31. This bus is supposed to be going down 5th Avenue. And the bus behind it, the Q32, also 5th Avenue.
Transcon Express, the next stop is Bleecker Street, followed by Brooklyn Bridge. Next train will go local.
That's unusual.
Thank you.
This is Infrared. We're in the Astor Place station on St. Patrick's Day, which is 3:17, March 17th, at 2:17 p.m. How about that? And we're here so that you don't have to be. On St. Patrick's Day afternoon. This sign, the A looks defective. What happened here?
There is a downtown local 6 train to Brooklyn Bridge City Hall. Approaching the station, please stand away from the platform edge.
This is from 1904, station original, and this was formerly the entrance to a Kmart. So in the afternoon of St. Patrick's Day, we've come to Astor Place to see two St. Patrick's Day institutions. One, which has been around for over 100 years. Another, a little bit shorter. Here, the pseudo classic subway station and actual Avion stainless steel or aluminum, I forget which, trailer. So this faux classic, which was built in the 1980s to replicate the standard subway kiosk that was designed into this system when it opened in 1904. It could use an upgrade itself. Cooper Union. Leave it to a design school to insist on better than usual sidewalk bridging. Reunion, the other building. Monument and Cooper, the standard Parks Department sign. Some of this area we covered on a previous walk through Little Ukraine. So, a popular place on St. Patrick's Day, well, Taipei beef noodles, probably, but, and some of the Ukrainian restaurants around here, probably, but it's uncharacteristically festive McSorley. Ago, as part of the Little Ukraine walk, we were able to just walk into McSorley's and sit down and imbibe, even though we chose not to, but we could have. So, how much longer will this line grow? Wow. When they get in, they will be very thirsty.
No, that's the only to run, I called it.
Over here. Whoa, yellow cab. Don't see too many of those these days. The church was built in 1976, even though it looks like it could be much older than that. McSorley's crowd one more time. Also, would you expect nothing less from an engineering and design school? As I said, there are two St. Patrick's Day institutions around here. We saw one of them. Pizza could be a St. Patrick's institution. Oh, I forgot the mosaic covered lampposts. Oh well.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. Here is the other St. Patrick's Day institution, but unlike McSorley's, which has been around for more than 100 years, this has been around for, I think, not even 100 days. In a previous walk, we showed this. One of only two licensed adult use cannabis stores in the city, I think. On opening day, the line went all the way around the block. All the way around. Anyway. We're past that. So that's the end of bonus feature number 4 or whatever. And this is infrared. And this is what you've been watching so far on St. Patrick's Day, 2023. And still St. Patrick's Day, about 2:45 in the afternoon, and we're near the West 4th Street stop, and just outside the NYU Stern School of Business, where even though it's mid-afternoon on St. Patrick's Day, looks pretty normal. After all, it's Stern School of Business. So, practically kitty corner to Stern School of Business. Well, across the street from that school is the Frederick Lowe Theater as part of the NYU Steinhardt School. I believe that's Steinhardt School of the Arts. thirsty anymore? But, as I started to say, we were kitty corner, catty corner, to Washington Square Park. Will Washington Square Park be any different on St. Patrick's Day? Is Washington Square Park ever the same on any 2 days? They're here to celebrate St. Patrick's Day. If, for those of you who have smell-o-vision activated now, there is little evidence of any enforcement of the rule that there's no smoking in any city park. I'm not even talking about selling here. I'm just talking about the smell. It's pervasive. Anyway.
Yeah, that's funny. That's cute.
And yet, can't see it.
Just to keep the peace, yeah?
Oh. Yep. Little evidence of St. Patrick's Day in Washington Square Park.
9 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah.
We'll see you in a bit.
For no fucking reason, because they added some mistakes.
There we go, a sign of St. Patrick's Day. So, this portion of the village, on St. Patrick's Day, a little after 3 p.m. This is infrared. we have at least one more St. Patrick's Day stop to make. For that, we're going to have to get on the train. See you soon. McSorley's Ale, and the first legalized weed establishment in the city. So, what are we doing here to close out our St. Patrick's Day celebration? said we were on the border between Park Slope and Windsor Terrace, but we actually are in Windsor Terrace at this point. Actually, we took the southernmost stairway exit from this station. There is one that's closer to our final destination, but I missed it. But as you can start to see from here, at the end of this block is Farrell's Bar and Grill. That sign doesn't tell us is that Farrell's Bar and Grill has been here in this very spot under this very name for 90 years. It was open in 1933. Some say that coincides with the end of Prohibition. I say it coincides with the completion of the subway to this neighborhood, to this stop. So, this is a place with the name Farrell's established 90 years ago. Are they doing a booming business on St. Patrick's Day? Well, this is their next door neighbor. Okay. You'll see I took the wrong stairway because if I had come up this exit, I would be right across from Farrell's. Right. This is infrared. This is what you've been watching. And just listen for a minute. The sounds of St. Patrick's Day.